Regarding Python, as well as we saw the data preprocessing template yesterday. In the today's session, we will start the machine learning. So coming to the machine learning, we will see the interaction with machine learning. After that, we will start the regression algorithm. So here I'm opening regression folder. So in this, I'm going to simple linear regression folder. I created this folder for you. So here I want to create new Python file. So here I'm creating new Python file. So coming to the machine learning, initially we will discuss the supervised learning. Initially we will discuss the supervised learning. So here coming to the supervised learning, it is classified into two types. So one is a regression and another one is the classification. First one is a regression unit and second one is a classification algorithms. So here classification, yeah. So here we can say whether it is a classification or regression problem based on the outcome or output. So if your output is the continuous, if output is continuous, so the problem is called as if output is continuous. That is nothing but if output is the magnitude value, we can say that such kind of problems are regression problem. Whereas if your output is the categorical data, so if output is categorical, we can say the problem as a classification problem. The best example for this regression problem is to predict the temperature prediction and house price prediction, and we need to predict the number of patients injured by specific disease on the specific day. So in this kind of scenario, we need to predict the magnitude value. So if your output is a continuous value, we need to use regression algorithms. And if your output is a categorical data, it is a categorical data means whether yes or no kind of answer, whether different multiple categorical data, such kind of cases, we need to use classification algorithms. So coming to this regression problem, so we have first algorithm as linear regression algorithm. So for this, first one is the linear regression problem or linear regression model. So how it works, we will discuss in the today's session. So again, coming to this linear regression, is divided into three major types. First one is the simple linear regression. So coming to this thing, first category is the simple linear regression. And in this second category is multiple linear regression. In this second category is multiple linear regression. So coming to third thing, it is a polynomial regression. Polynomial, so we can say this thing also, polynomial linear regression. So here, these are the different types of linear regression algorithm. So coming to the simple linear regression, if you have one dependent variable as well as one independent, aware of this equation, that is y equals to mx plus c equation. So if you apply this equation, so here if you observe, here we have only one independent variable as well as one dependent variable. On such cases, we need to use simple linear regression. So if your output is depend on single independent variable, that is said as simple linear regression. Whereas coming to this multiple linear regression, if your outcome is depend on multiple variables, so let us assume, so here I'm taking line equation as m1 x1, so here I'm saying m1 x1 plus, sorry, here I want to say, yeah, here only we need to say, yeah, here on the right. So here let us assume, so here I'm saying m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus so on dash. So whatever the input variables you have, you can specify that many input variables here. And finally, we need to specify c. So here, if your output is depend on multiple input variables, that is said as multiple linear regression. That is multiple linear regression. So in today's class, we will discuss the simple linear regression as well as multiple linear regression. Coming to the next class, we will discuss one more topic called as polynomial regression. So after finishing this session, after explaining this entire code regarding the simple linear regression as well as multiple linear regression, I will forward you the simple video. So that shows. So if you see that video, you will get the complete intuition of this simple linear regression as well as multiple linear regression. So before that thing, we will discuss the data set which we have for simple linear regression problem. So here, coming to this intent folder. So here I created the regression folder for you. In it, I kept a simple linear regression. Here I have salarydata.csv. So here I have one CSV file. So initially we will observe the data which is present in it. Yes, it is the data set which I have. So here if you observe, we have only two columns. First column is years of experience and second column is the salary. That means based on the years of experience, we need to predict the salary of the specific person. Let us assume I have one company. I want to hire a new person to my company. So that person have specific experience on that specific domain. So based on that experience, I want to decide his salary. So I don't want to decide the salary manually. So for that purpose, I want to apply simple algorithm. So machine needs to predict his salary based on his experience. To solve this kind of such kind of problems, here we need to use simple linear regression algorithm. So if you observe this example, here we have only one independent variable and here we have salary as an output. So here it is the data set which we have. So after that, so I will explain you the intuition of this model. So let us assume here I am taking one whiteboard. On this whiteboard, I am plotting the graph. So if you observe here, I am plotting the graph. So let us assume, so here it is the experience. So on the x-axis, I am taking experience. So here let us assume it is an experience call, experience axis. On the y-axis, I want to keep salary. So here, based on this his experience, I want to decide his salary. Let us assume we have data set. In the data set, we have salaries like so few values. So let us assume here, here, here. Let us assume we have few points. So let us assume this. Let us assume these are the few data points. So let us assume, so here it is a different data type. So based on the experience, salaries will be distributed in this fashion. So based on this data, we need to predict a line. So here we need to predict which hyperplane. So here, as I already told you, so in the simple linear regression, we need to consider this equation. So here I'm saying equation as y equals to mx plus c. So here, coming to this example, here y is nothing but our salary. In this example, y is nothing but our salary and x is nothing but years of experience. And we need to predict what is the best slope as well as what is an intercept point corresponding to this thing. Let us assume initially I am drawing one line. So here I am drawing one line. So here I want to check, I want to know whether this line is the best fit for this algorithm or not. To know whether this line is good fit or not, we need to use cost function. So we need to check whether this line is the best fit or not. For that purpose, we need to use cost function. So here cost function, the equation for cost function is, so initially, so for this thing, initially, I will change the color. So here, initially I want to calculate the cost function. To calculate the cost function, so here I am saying this one as my prediction line. So this prediction line will be says as y hat. So here y hat is nothing but it is an hypothesis. So here it is an hypothesis and these all points are said as actual points. So here we need to calculate the cost function. We need to know the distance between this actual and this real point. So here we have real point here, and here our actual prediction is lies here. So we need to calculate the difference between these two points. So it is called as a difference between these two points. Like that, we need to predict the difference between each and every point. So here, let us assume, so if the person have 4 years experience, so here I'm saying, let the person have 4 years experience, my algorithm will be predicting the salary with this specific point. That is nothing but, so here I'm saying, in the dollars, some $10,000. So initially I'm saying some $10,000. So whereas, if I am applying this prediction line, my prediction line is predicting as 8K. So here I'm saying 8K. So here we have 2000 error. So in between these two points, we have 2000 error. So like that, for each and every point, we need to calculate the cost function. So whereas if you observe here, we have cost function is nothing but, so here I'm saying y hat. So initially I'm saying this equation, y hat minus yi. So here I'm saying yi is nothing but our real point, our actual point. Here I'm saying y hat is nothing but the point corresponding to same level at this location. So here if you calculate cost function for this point, it will return the positive cost. So here if you apply this thing, it will return the positive cost. Whereas if you apply same thing for this point, so here if you apply same thing here, it will return negative cost. So here it will return negative cost. So if you add up all the points, so here we are getting sometime positive number and sometime we are getting negative number. So most of the time this positive will be cancelled with this negative, and here this cost function won't return any error. So to overcome this problem, here we are taking absolute value for this thing. Here we are converting every value in the form of positive only. That means we are taking the magnitude of the error only. So here, always, so here initially I said as this one as in my initial line. So like that, our algorithm will, so here it is a one regression line. So I want to plot different regression line. So our algorithm will consider lot of regression line. So it will consider one more line in this fashion. It will consider one more line on that fashion. It will consider one more line like this. Like that, our algorithm plot different regression lines. So here, in which line it goes to minimum cost function. So always we try to reduce this error. So here cost function is nothing but error. Always we try to reduce this cost function. So whatever the line having minimum cost function, our algorithm will consider that point as a final point. So here, whichever the line returns the minimum cost function, that will be considered as a final regression line. So our algorithm will only take care of this thing. So if you want to understand internal working of the specific regression lines, I will forward you the one video session with you. So which is having 12 minutes of duration. If you watch that video, you will get complete intuition behind this thing. So to measure the cost function, we have different function. One function is, it is called as mean absolute error function. To calculate this cost function, we need to use mean absolute error function. Like this mean absolute error function, we have mean absolute squared function also. Mean squared error also. So if we can take the mean square error also. So always we try to reduce this cost function only. Whatever the minimum value of this cost function, that will be considered as our optimum regression line. So here in this intuition, in this thing, we need to do that thing only. So coming to this thing, C is called as intercept point. Here C is nothing but it is an intercept. So coming to practical scenario, it means, so here I'm saying this point as an intercept. So let us assume, so here if you observe this point here, it is an intercept. So here it is nothing but, so if the person, what is the base salary of the specific person if he is a fresher? So here it is nothing but intercept point. So here with the zero experience, how much salary that person will get, that is nothing but this intercept point. Intercept is nothing but, so here in this example, on the zero axis, how much salary that specific person get, that is nothing but cost rate, intercept point, and it's a slope. So for the unit change in experience, how much salary will be varied? Unit change in experience, how much salary will be varied per that specific person, that is nothing but slope. Slope is but for unit change in x-axis, how much magnitude varied in y-axis, that is nothing but slope. After that, we have x, that is nothing but experience. We need to multiply this slope with the experience. Find the point. So with the, so here in this example, intercept is, remember this thing, intercept is nothing but with the zero experience. That is, if he is a fresher, how much salary he will get as a base salary? That is nothing but intercept. So here, if you want to perform multiple linear regression, so if you have more than one input variable, that problem will be said as multiple linear regression problem. So here, it is the theory behind simple linear regression. We will see this thing in the program now. Yeah, good. So here I created one new file. I want to open that new file. So here I already opened that file, I think. So here we are opening one file. So for this file, I want to keep name as simple linear regression. Tutorial. So here, these are the different metrics to evaluate your model or your prediction line. So to type this thing, it will take more time. For that purpose, I kept this entire portion in the data preprocessing template. So here I'm copy pasting same thing in our simple linear regression algorithm. So here, and I'm converting this thing in the form of markdown. So I want to convert this thing in the form of text. So here, these are the different metrics to check whether your line is optimum line or not. So here you can consider the mean absolute error, as well as you can consider mean squared error, or you can consider root mean squared error. So these are the measures to calculate the cost function. So our algorithm only takes care of this thing. So whatever the minimum cost function is there, with that minimum cost function, our regression line will be come by default. So here yesterday we saw, initially we need to import essential libraries. Whenever you want to work with any machine learning algorithm, so initially we need to import essential libraries. So coming to our project, what are the essential libraries? So first one is the NumPy. So initially we need to import NumPy with some alias name. After that, another essential library is Pandas. So here I'm saying import. So I am importing Pandas also. After this, we have one more essential library, that is import matplotlib dot pyplot as plt. So these are the three essential libraries to perform any mathematical computations in machine learning. So here, so this portion is running. After that, I will start one more portion. That is, we need to import data set. After this, we need to import the data set. So how to import the data set? So in the Pandas, we have read function, which is used to read the data set. And we need to store that variable. So here I'm saying data equals to, I want to read the entire data which is present in the CSV file. To read the CSV file, we need to use read underscore CSV function. Here I'm saying read underscore CSV. So in this read underscore CSV, we need to specify the file name. So if you go to the folder, what is the file name? Here we have salary data dot CSV. So here we have name like salary data dot CSV. So I think it is only the name for that CSV file. I'm running this portion. Yeah, good. Executed successfully. That means same name we kept for that thing. So after the thing, we need to divide this data set in the form of dependent variable as well as independent variable. So if you observe our data set, so here in this data set, how many rows and how many columns we have? We have only one row. Sorry, we have only two columns. One is an independent variable. Another one is a dependent variable. The salary base depends on this experience. That's why here I'm saying this one as an dependent variable and this years of experience as an independent variable. So here we need to say column 0 corresponding to x-axis and column y corresponding to output. So that's what I want to specify here. Here I want to say x equals to dot dot dot. I want to use index location function only. So whatever the function convenient to you, you can use that function. I want to access the data present in each and every row. After that, I want to specify the data corresponding to all the columns except the last column. So here colon minus one is nothing but except the last column, we are accessing the values which are present in each and every column. So here finally we use dot values to access all the values present on that specific column. We need to specify this thing. After that, we need to specify y-axis. So we need to specify y-axis. So for that purpose also, I am using same thing. So here I'm saying data dot I location function. In this function, I want to access the data which is present in all the rows, and I want to access the data which is present in the first column. To access the data which is present in the first column, here I'm saying 1:2, which is nothing but here I'm including the first column and here I'm excluding the second column. That means if you observe the data set, there we have only two columns only, that is 0th index as well as first index. That means here we are accessing the data which is present in the first column only. So here we are accessing the values corresponding to both the things, and I'm running this portion. And I want to observe the data which is present in X. So here in X contains the years of experience. So if you observe the data which is present in Y, it will return the salary corresponding to each and every person. And if you observe the data set, so here I want to observe the data. So if you observe the data, so here it is the data which we have on that specific CSV file. So here we have 30 instances. So here the years of experience will be starts with by default index 0, and here we have it is ended with 29. That means here we have 30 samples in our data set. We have 30 samples. After that, what we need to do? So here initially we imported essential libraries and we read the CSV file. After that, we specified input as well as output parameters. After that, what we need to do? We need to split the data set in the form of training and test sets. So if you observe this data set here, we don't have any missing values. If you observe here, we don't have any missed values. So every sample is specified properly only. So here we can easily apply a mathematical equation on this. We need not to preprocess this data, and here we don't have missing values also. So for that purpose, we need not to perform preprocessing steps. After that, what we need to say, we need to split this data set in the form of training and test split. So test split, for that purpose I'm copy pasting same thing. So here next, splitting the data set into training and test set. So after this, we need to split the data set in the form of training and test set. So here I'm saying, here to split the data set, here we need to use model selection. In the model selection, we need to use train test split class. So here, whenever you created the class with a specific class name, we need to create an object. So here I'm creating object with the train test split. So here inside this thing, I want to specify, we need to specify input variable as well as output variable. That is nothing but independent variable as well as dependent variable. After that, we need to specify the test size. In this example, I am specifying optimum test size. That is nothing but I want to consider 20% of data to test my algorithm. After that, remaining 80% will be considered for training. I am executing. So here we divided the data set in the form of training and test sets. Yeah, good. It is executed successfully. So now I want to observe the data which is present in xtrain variable. So if you observe the data present in xtrain variable, here we have 24 samples. If you observe here, if you count all the samples, so 80% in 30 is nothing but it will consider 24 samples. Whereas if you test the data which is present in xtest, remaining 6 samples will be considered for testing the output. So here it is considering these 6 samples for testing the data. Like that, if you observe the Y train as well as Y test also, it will return same thing. In the Y train, you have these 24 samples. These 24 samples is nothing but it will return the output. So here I'm saying Y test. So here Y test is nothing but corresponding to this years of experience, how much salary he will get. That is nothing but test set data. So after that, to this data, we need to apply our linear regression model. So for that purpose also, we need to take, so again, we need to take help of the linear, I'm saying, it is defined in the linear model module. So from the sklearn package, we need to use this linear model package. So in this package or in this module, so here we need to input linear regression. So here we need to input linear regression class. So here I imported the linear regression class. Whenever you import the linear regression class, with that specific class name, we need to create an object, and I want to store that object in regressor variable. So here I'm storing that variable in the regressor variable. So here we need to create an object with this class name. Here we need to create an object with this specific class name. I'm doing the same thing here, and I'm running this portion. So here we need to fit our model, this regression model, to our training data. We need to fit this model to our training data. So we stored this linear regression model. We stored this linear regression object to this in this regressor variable. So whenever you want to access a linear regression model, we need to access with the regressor only. So here we need to fit this model to our training data. So here I'm saying I want to train the machine by using xtrain as well as ytrain. By using training data, I want to train the machine. So here with this training will be completed. To train the machine learning algorithm, always we need to use fit method. So here whenever you want to apply any equation on the data, here we need to use a fit method. So I fitted this data to this training data to our machine learning algorithm. So based on this data, I want to predict the outcome. So here I want to predict the outcome. To predict the outcome, so here I am using one more variable. To predict the outcome in the regressor object itself, so here regressor object itself, we have predict method. To predict the output, we have predict method. So in the predict, we need to predict the output for x test. We need to predict the output for x test. So here I'm saying x test. So here after this, I am seeing the output which is present in y predicted. So here it is the predicted output. So for this test sample, it is the predicted output. So I want to compare this thing with the test set result. So here, if you observe this thing with the test set result, here it is the comparison. So here actually we have the actual salary as 37,731 rupees, whereas our algorithm predicting this thing as 40,748 rupees. Like that. So in the second thing, we have 1,21 rupees. So here our algorithm predicting like 1,22,699. So here it predicting very closely. That means our algorithm will working properly only. So to test how your model is working, we need to use predict method. So after this thing, what we need to do? So here, let assume, so in the, yeah, if you observe the data set, we have a lot of values. I want to predict the salary of the specific person who is having experience of 6.5 years. So here, to predict that thing, what we need to do? Here again, we need to use regressor object only. So here, regressor.predict. So in this predict, I want to predict the salary of the specific person who is having, he's having 6.5 years experience. So here I'm specifying 6.5. Whenever you specify 6.5, it will return output as this thing. That means our algorithm predicting like, so if the person have 6.5 years experience, I want to predict his salary as 87,300.